Andy, this is the first broadcast you've done with your new band since the demise of Amen Corner. What's been keeping you busy in the interim?
Mainly finishing work on our album, plus the fact that we just decided on spec to release the single, which we went down into the studio and actually recorded it. It was rush released as quick as any company could ever get a single out.
Before we talk about the record, have you done any live gigs at all?
We've done about five, and they're going down really well.
Have these in any way governed the kind of material you've put on the new single?
Yeah, we decided that for once we'd find out what went down well on stage rather than work something out in the studio and think, oh, this is what we should do. We know what goes down well on stage, so therefore we transferred it to putting it on plastic.
And on one side of the record is a real good old rock and roll classic, isn't there? Little Richard number. And having listened to the record, it doesn't sound to me so very different after all these years. You haven't tried to sort of dress it up 70s style.
No, not really. The number's basically there, the feel that Little Richard originally had. Oh. And it's this feel that's transferred to all those early rock records.
Yeah.
You can do something with them that, if you make your own type of rock, it quite doesn't come off the same.
And this is the sort of thing you've been doing in the gigs that you've done?
Yeah, we do include Tutti Frutti in the act, but it's more such as numbers like Road to Freedom, which are actually the act. But yeah. Tutti Frutti goes down a real storm.
Great. Well, we're going to hear Road to Freedom right now. This is one of your own numbers.
Yeah.
Is this the A side of the record?
Well, it is a double A side, but it's Road to Freedom, the one myself and the group favour.
Andy, let's hear it live.
Thanks very much.